particular role-playing scenario. First of all, I talked a little about what is meant by meaningful feedback. And if I just quote from the manual, feedback isn't about pointing out flaws. It's about motivating someone to improve. Feedback should be a dual effort between the leader and the team member with the tools and direction he or she needs to perform work properly. End of quote. Feedback isn't all about giving praise to somebody. It's about trying to help them improve through their work. Therefore, it cannot be all negative at the same time. And so today, what we're going to be doing is I am going to be, I guess I could say, the boss, and John LeCompte will be my manager. And John has a series of customer service representatives that work for him. There's been a dilemma, something's come up, and I'm going to try to ask John some questions to try to probe him to see why things went wrong, and indeed perhaps how they could be improved. John has been a star performer, and so his department has indeed been functioning very well. However, recently, as I say, we've run into some problems, and those are the problems we're going to discuss. Please help me welcome John LeCompte.
John, how are you doing?
Oh, I'm doing great.
Good.
Glad that I'm back from the hot East Coast.
Okay. And managed the heat okay?
Survived it. Happier now.
Good, good, good. You've done extremely well for a long time. However, recently I've noticed that in your department there have been a couple things that have come up, which perhaps I'd like to discuss with you. Is that you good?
Yeah, that's cool.
Good. So, one thing I've noticed in particular is that people really, really enjoy working for you. And I think that is fantastic.
That's not one of the things going wrong.
Yeah, exactly. And I think that, in fact, it reminds me, we in Seattle Wireless have been nominated for the second year in a row, and I think you know this, second year in a row as being the best place in Seattle to work. And I think that's fantastic, and I certainly congratulate you personally, because your team has been up there amongst the people that have really enjoyed working for you. In fact, I just met Janice. I believe she's one of your star customer service reps, and she was just all over the map saying she was excited that how she worked for you.
That's excellent feedback.
So maybe actually before, what perhaps you could explain what have you done, you feel, that makes your place such an exciting place to work at?
Well, one of the things that I think is really important is that in customer service reps, a lot of times people will call up whatever service it is, and have somebody pick up the phone from anywhere, across the country, across the world, who doesn't really have a local feel or connection. Well, all of our people are local, and they live and work in the neighborhood, and they feel a lot more responsibility, and I think that's very important.
That's fantastic. I can see it now. The headline, Seattle Times, third year in a row.
We're going to bring it.
Yeah, I think it's fantastic. That I can't give all the credit to HR, that's for sure. Human Resource Department, of course, they've got the 401k, and as we know, that they're trying to match the donations to that, and they're also trying to, I guess, give a little bit of a signing bonus. As we all know, it's very difficult in this particular environment to hire candidates and keep good people. So certainly there must be more to it than HR and what you've talked about so far. What else do you do that you feel is keeping your people so excited to work for you?
Well, I very much consider myself in a service leadership role. I try to remove roadblocks for my people and keep a feeling of trust and flexibility within my work group. So, for example, just last week, Janice had to go and pick up her car at the shop. So I went ahead and let her go ahead and take off early to go and pick up her car. So she knows that I'm supporting her in the, you know, the little tribulations and details of life.
That sounds very fair. And so did you let Janice go? Did you fill in her position at all?
Well, to cover for
her
absence.
Yeah.
Well, it was only half an hour before the end of her shift, yeah. So I didn't make any adjustment for that.
That would have been Thursday afternoon, I think, probably. Right, because it's interesting to note that, John, because that brings me to the point that I want to talk a bit about the problem that we've encountered, and that is that our system for tracking customer complaints actually showed a little bit of a spike in waiting times right then. And I was a little surprised to see that. And certainly you yourself mentioned Thursday afternoons was a time when we were most busy. Do you think that maybe next time would make sense to have somebody fill in for that role?
Having this feedback is really important. I didn't realize that spike in complaints or wait times was there at that moment. And it goes to show, I mean, you did mention Janice is a real star performer, and so her absence was felt. I think that we need to make an adjustment, that I need to make an adjustment there. And so maybe with future times, I can make a rule, still try to be flexible, but have people announce in advance when they're going to be gone, and then make any adjustments that I need to backfill.
Sounds perfect. Two-way street there, for sure. You're being responsible to them, and they were being responsible to you. I think that's fantastic. I look forward to another great year, John. Thanks so much.